Good morning, children. Chapter 3, Pair of Linear Equations. We are going to do word problems only. The first question, a boat covers 32 km upstream and 36 km downstream in 7 hours. Also, it covers 40 km upstream and 48 km downstream in 9 hours. Find the speed of the boat in still water and that of the stream. Such type of the questions we already solved last years. We have to assume the speed of the boat in the still water, speed of the boat in the stream, and the upstream as well as downstream speed also we should write. So that is the common step we have to remember before doing the sum. So we'll assume, let the speed of the boat in still water equal to x kilometer per hour, speed of the stream y kilometer per hour. Okay, next we should write upstream and downstream cases. So we should write speed of the upstream equal to x minus y, speed of the downstream x plus y kilometer per hour. See, when we are doing the cycling and all upstream, the journey is difficult, speed will be less. So still water minus stream, and downstream speed will be more. So both should be added, x plus y kilometer per hour. These four steps we should remember. Okay, now what is the next step? Boat covers 32 kilometer upstream, 36 kilometer downstream in 7 hours. So I'll write here case one. Time equal to 7 hours. And speed of the upstream, we'll write a two section of this one, upstream, downstream. In upstream, what is the distance? 32 kilometer. Downstream, distance equal to 36 kilometers. Speed we already calculated, it is upstream x minus y, downstream x plus y. See, we know the formula, time equal to distance by speed only. By using this one, we can write what is the distance, 32 by x minus y, that is upstream, 36 by x plus y, that is downstream, equal to time, equal to 7 hours. So that is the first equation. But I'll put equation number 1. Similarly, case 2. Case 2, what is the time? Time 9 hours. Upstream and downstream. Distance 40 kilometer is upstream, 48 kilometer is downstream. Speed normal only of formula x minus y, x plus y. Again, what is the time? 9 hours. So 40 by x minus y plus 48 by x plus y equal to 9. So equation number 2. So 1 and 2 here only you can see. So I'll write, just put 1 by x minus y equal to u and 1 by x plus y equal to v. Then we have 32 u plus 36 V equal to 7. Okay, next 40 U plus 48 V equal to 9. I will write in the standard form only. 32 U plus 36 V minus 7 equal to 0. 40 U plus 48 V minus 9 equal to 0. We'll go for a cross multiplication method only. So V coefficients we should start. 36, 48, minus 7, minus 9, 32, 40, again 36, 48. U, V, 1. Applying cross multiplication rule. U divided by 36 into minus 9 minus bracket 48 into minus 7. V divided by minus 7 into 40 minus 9 into 32. 1 divided by 32 into 48 minus 40 into 36. You will get U divided by minus 324 plus 336 equal to V divided by minus 280 plus 288 equal to 1 by 1536 minus 1440. That is U divided by 12 with the plus sign equal to V divided by 8 equal to 1 divided by 96. So what is U? 12 by 96 equal to 1 by 8 and V equal to 8 by 96 equal to 1 by 12. So we got U and V now. Now what is our U? We have taken as 1 by U equal to 1 by X minus Y, which is equal to 1 by 8, and V equal to 1 by X plus Y, which is equal to 1 by 12. This implies X minus Y equal to 8 and X plus Y equal to 12. Now again elimination we can go for. So one below the other I'll write. Adding 2x equal to 20 means x equal to 10. Similarly, therefore y equal to 12 minus x equal to 12 minus 10 equal to 2. So x equal to 10 and y equal to 2. So what is our x and y? Speed of the boat in the still water. Equal to 10 km per hour and a stream, speed of the stream (2 km per hour). So for this question, whatever we have told in the beginning, if you remember that one, it will be easy only. Two women and five men can together finish an embroidery work in 4 days, while three women and six men can finish it in 3 days. Find the time taken by the one woman alone to finish the work and also that taken by one man alone. So this is also one of the important questions only. It is time and work done questions only. So such questions, we should take that. Number of days taken by one woman to complete the work. Complete the work equal to X days. That means one woman need x days to complete the work. So the question is, one day work, how much she will do? X days, total complete work is x day. So 1 day's work means 1/x. Now the question is for two women are there. So one woman's this one, two women, 1 day work, how much they will do? 2 × 1/x, that means 2/x. So this is woman's case. Similarly, men, we have to do number of days taken by one man to complete the work. Y days. Therefore, one man's 1 day work. 1/y part, isn't it? Next, how many men are there in the first question, case 1? 5 men. 5 men. Okay. 5 men in 1 day work equal to 5/y. So the first statement we will write now, 2 women and 5 men so 1 day work equal to 2/x + 5/y. Now they together work for 4 days and work, the work is completed. So I'll write the statement. According to the question, 2 women and 5 men can finish the work in 4 days. So mathematically, what we can write, this is 1 day's work. So 4 × 2/x + 5/y equal to the complete work. So it is equal to 1. So complete work is represented by 1 only. So what is 2/x + 5/y? It is equal to 1/4, equation number 1. Similarly, the second part of the question, three women and 6 men can finish the work in 3 days. That means 3 × 3/x + 6/y equal to 1, or 3/x + 6/y equal to 1/3. See, from where I got this one, we already written 1 day's work equal to 1/x and 1 day's work for man equal to 1/y. So for 3 women are there, so we multiplied. 6 men are there, so we multiplied. So 3/x + 6/y equal to 1/3. So you can see the first and the second equation. What I should do now, put 1/x equal to u and 1/y equal to v, then equation 1 and 2 can be written as (2u + 5v = 1/4). 3u + 6v equal to 1/3. So we are multiplying this equation, that is equation 3 and equation 4. So I'm making the coefficients of u are equal. So into 3 here, into 2 here. So that is equal to 6u plus 15v equal to 3 by 4. 6u plus 12v equal to 2 by 3. Subtraction, change of sign, get cancel. So 3v equal to 3 by 4 minus 2 by 3. So 12 here into 3 into 8, sorry, into 4. So 9 minus 8 divided by 12, that is 1 by 12. That is 3v equal to 1 by 12, or v equal to 1 by 12 into 3, that is equal to 1 by 36. Now put v equal to 1 by 36 in equation 3. Do u plus 5 into 1 by 36 equal to 1 by 4? Do u equal to 1 by 4 minus 5 by 36? So into 9. 9 minus 5, 4 by 36, which is equal to 1 by 9. Therefore, u equal to 1 by 9 into 2, which is equal to 1 by 18. So the first step we got v as 1 by 36 and u as 1 by 18. Now what is our u and v? So u equal to 1 by x equal to 1 by 18 implies x equal to 18. Similarly, v equal to 1 by y equal to 1 by 36 implies y equal to 36. So what is our x and y? Number of days taken by a woman to complete the work is 18 days. For man, it is 36 days. So that is the conclusion. Number of days taken by one woman to complete the work. Equal to x, that means 18 days. Also, number of days taken by one man to complete the work, 36 days. Both the questions are very important only. You do practice these questions. It is required also. Next question. A person rowing at the rate of 5 km per hour in still water takes thrice as much as time in going upstream and as in going 40 km downstream. So find the speed of this stream only. Little bit confusion is there by the sentence thrice only. Other than that, it is an easy question only. So I already told such type of the questions, we should assume the things like the speed rowing at the rate of, let us take the boat only, speed of the boat in still water equal to x kilometer per hour. Next, speed of the stream equal to y kilometer per hour. Speed of upstream x minus y, and speed of downstream x plus y. After that, we should substitute according to the question. At the rate of 5 km per hour in the still water, that means x is 5. So this will be 5 minus y, and this will be 5 plus y. Okay. okay. So these terms you make it clear in your mind, then the questions are very easy. So he takes thrice as much as time in going 40 kilometer upstream and 40 kilometer downstream. So distance is same. What is the difference? He takes time thrice as much as time is going the upstream. So we'll write here, according to the question, time for upstream is 3 times time for downstream. So time is, what is the speed, what is the formula? Distance by speed. What is the distance? 40 divided by 5 minus y equal to 3 into 40 divided by 5 plus y. Now 40 we can cancel, cross multiply. 5 plus y equal to 3 into 5 minus y, so it is equal to 15 minus 3y. Y are on one side, so it is 4y equal to 15 minus 5 equal to 10. So y equal to 10 by 4, 5 by 2, which is equal to 2.5 kilometer per hour. So y equal to 2.5. So what is the speed of this stream? Kilometer per hour. With this, today's class I am winding up. Practice more. This all three questions are very important. The last question is from NCERT exemplar only. So do practice more.